Today, friends, we are going to use Tinkercad's sweet Sketch Revolve to make a fun fidget. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. Of course, you can get there with the link up above. I simply choose sign in with Google. This is the homepage. Right here are our designs. Now, we're going to do a quick history lesson. If I search fidget, this searches my designs right here. If we search up here, these are the world's designs. As you can see, there are a ton of fidgets. The one I am looking for is my print-in-place fidget, so I'm going to simply hit tinker this. No, this design is private, so I'm the only one that can see it, but I'm going to hit tinker this and just show you quickly what's inside. So this tutorial is built off the cone and cylinder. This is how I used to make a center, and then we had an outside. We cut it out, and then when you were done, you had a fidget where you could hold the top and the bottom and spin the outsides. You can make it as fancy as you wanted. These are parts that we cut off. I'll real quickly ungroup this so you can see how I took cylinders, rotated around to get that fancy texture for my fidget. Now, instead of this old style, today we're gonna do this with Sketch Revolve. So I'm gonna simply make sure you're on the Designs tab and let's hit Create New 3D Design. I like to start by naming it. Of course, we're gonna call this one Fun Fidget. If you wanted to put the word sketch in there so you could find it later, that would be sweet too. So we're going to bring out the sketch tool. When you bring it in, notice I'm zooming in. That lets you see the dotted lines, which show how it fits in a 20 by 20 grid. Notice there was a dotted line in Z as well. So this is the sketch tool. If you've never seen it before, this is the sketch features list. It is fantastic. They show you all the things in here as they update them. You can check this all the time at your leisure. Cool animations, and of course, all kinds of fantastic information. When you're done checking out, you can simply return to your design right here. If you prefer my tutorials, I've got a playlist full of them. I will put the bit.ly up here. Of course, you can also check for a link in the cards. In the interface, I will highlight you've got three tools over here for drawing straight lines, bezier curves, and smooth curves. And you can also clear the design. Up here, we can recenter home, zoom, and this one is fit view. Of course, I will highlight these shortcuts as well. And then you can also copy and paste pieces. So right now, we're going to use straight lines to build our fidget. Start right here on this brown line, and we're going to move out, and you're doing the radius. So if I do a radius of 10, that means I've got 2 centimeters for that core. Well, I want less than 2 centimeters. I'm going to do 14 millimeters, so I'm only going out 7. Now I want this core to slope up just like my old cone, and I'm going to have it move to a 10 centimeter mark. So I'm counting out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's going to be the core for the inside. I'm going to make that distance going up 10 millimeters. That's just nice for making the math easy. And then once again, we're going to go out 10 millimeters and we're going to go to that same 8 spot and bring it over and then connect it down. We have just made the core for her shape, but check it out. I screwed up. There's no problem though. We can simply double click and see how I chose 8. And down here, I chose 7. I just forgot. I can click on that point and I can use the arrow key to nudge it back where I want. And when I double click to finish it, there is our core. To draw the outside of our fidget, we're just simply going to make sure we double clicked. We're going to hit P for pen. And we're going to just go 1 millimeter past for each of those points. Click, click, click. And then we can come out here and decide what we want our shape to look like. So I'm going to move out 2 millimeters past, come straight up, and then just finish it. If we look at this from the top, you can see that we have got a shape that's going to go around the outside, and we're going to have that core in the middle. That is the secret of our fun fidget. Now I'm going to make this a tiny bit more advanced by double-clicking, hitting number 4 to add points. Notice right now I can't be super picky, so I'm just going to add 4 points. And then I want to remind you, you've got to hit V to stop being in add-delete mode. Now I'm going to grab these points and get them where I want. If I look right here, I came down 6 millimeters. I think I'm going to make that 7. This one already was at 7. Now I'm going to quickly nudge these so they are 2 millimeters away from those points. Now I can click on this line, and I'm just going to use the arrow key to nudge it out. Check it out on our design. You can see how that is going to have a little bump. And then I'm going to trim that bump so that we've got a place for our fingers to move. I'm going to do that outside here. Let's hit finish. There is our fun fidget. If you hit T for transparent, you can see inside how that is going to print, and you're going to be able to hold this while you spin that. It is a silly little project, but it does show how print in place works, which is really slick for people just learning 3D printing. So let's add the indents. We are going to do that with the sketch tool. So we've got Sketch Revolve and we've got Sketch. Notice I am putting it in the 20 by 20 grid. I'm not trying to put it in there because it'll land on top, but I am lining it up along the same axis. That lets me zoom in and get a good view of this. Of course, once again, you've got sketch features. Make sure you keep track of these. They do change. Both of these are a little bit different. I'm going to go up here and I'm going to start with a straight line. I'm moving 2 millimeters away and I'm going 2 millimeters past. Now I'm going to hit number 3 to do a smooth curve. Check this out. It automatically makes that shape a little bit rounded as I go 2 over. I'm going to go 1 up. I'm going to go 2 over. And I'm going to go back to connect it. So it just made this interesting little shape that's going to cut little teeth into my project. I can adjust the nudge with the arrow keys. If I go to a micro nudge, like 0.25, you can be more precise. Now, as you're designing, if these dimensions are ever in your way, you can simply hide them with Shift-D or by clicking this button. Now, I want one of these at each of these spots. So I'm going to do Control-C. And I'm going to do Control-Shift-V. That way it lands in the same spot, which makes it easier for nudging. I am doing Shift-Nudge to move it down. When I get it close to the right spot, I want to flip it. Here's a cool secret hack. This hack is fantastic. Bring your dimensions back and just change the number to negative in the direction you want to flip it. So if I change that to negative 2.4, bang, it's aimed the way I want. Then I can just use my nudge to get it so it matches the other side. See how this little corner comes inside this ring and that ring? That makes them the same, so now I can hit Finish Sketch. I want this part to be taller than the whole item. Double check that it's going to cut, and then I'm going to make multiples of this. Notice this rotation handle. This makes this super slick. Control D. And when we rotate, if you stay inside this arrow, it's 22.5 degrees. If you see right here where I went to 45 degrees, that's a nice gap. If you do not click anything else and do Control D again and again, it does that duplicate over and over to make a sweet shape. I'm going to turn those into holes. I'm going to click on our inside shape and shut off transparency by hitting the letter T. That gives you a better idea of how it's going to cut out. And let's finally do Control G to union group. Notice these do take a little longer because this shape is complex. But after a moment, you have got a super cool little fidget that when you use your fingertips to hold the middle, you are going to be able to spin it. If you're using these in a classroom, it's super cool to put initials on them. I'm going to do that real quickly with the built-in text. I'm going to set this right on top. I'm going to change the letters to HL. I'm going to do shift squeeze to make it tiny. Make sure it sits on top of that little pedestal or the center. Make it a hole and then set the thickness to 0.5. That's how far I want to cut it in. When I select everything and do L for align, I'm simply going to click on our main fidget and set them at the same height. I will also do L for align, and I forgot to hit center and center. Bang! Fully designed, I can grab it all and do Control G to group. Let's quickly get this sent to the 3D printer. Of course, it is export, selected shape, STL. I'm going to choose to put mine in my 3D modeling folder. Notice if your browser does not ask where you want to save, that is a browser setting. I will put a video with a bit.ly up here if you want to change your browser to work like this as well. I'm going to keep the name Fun Fidget, and let's quickly bounce to Bambu Studio. Create a new project. Let's add that file. Once again, fun fidget. There is our fun shape. I'm going to choose to print it with my gold PLA. Simply change filament to that generic PLA. I'm going to use this standard 0.2 setting. Let's slice the plate and check it out. The design is going to take about 30 minutes. Print plate, check those colors, and let's send it for 3D printing. All right, so real quickly, of course, you can click on your design and make it a fun color. If you want to show the world or me what you made, check this out. Simply click back to the Tinkercad workspace. Click the gear. Check the properties. Of course, give it a good name. Note my description says the tutorial's coming soon. There's also information about how to reach me and the HLMT23 tag. This is the tag. Please add it to your designs, because when you do this, I check it every day, and of course, I will give you a reaction. Finally, make the design public. If you want the world to be able to have fun and play with your design, leave it as share alike. If you want the world to just be able to see it, set it as no derivatives. I'm going to let this one be share alike because I'm choosing to give it away today. When you hit save changes, it is public and shared to the gallery. When you click on the gallery, you initially see the amazing staff picks. These are always fantastic. Make sure you take a moment to give them a reaction. This little critter actually runs in SibLab and was created to celebrate the 100 million Tinkercad users. ZDP, that's fantastic. I recommend you stop in here and check out these fantastic creations as often as you can. Of course, take it a moment to give a reaction as well. Of course, if you see one of my designs, I do want to remind you that, of course, there will likely be a tutorial in it. Those reactions are always appreciated. There will likely be cool links down below. Of course, Team HLMT23 will highlight that in just a moment. And if you want to see all of my designs, you can click right here. Right now, though, let's simply shut off the staff picks. I always love to check these out and give reactions. You never know just whose day you might be making. Xavier, that's fantastic. And of course, check it out. After a moment, there's the new fun fidget. To get to that HLMT23 tag, you can type the bit.ly or just type HLMT23 and press enter. Note, when you first visit, this is sorted by relevance. I'm going to set to recent. And check out all the amazing users that are taking time to share their designs. There are thousands of amazing designs. And of course, I have given them all reactions. Please check them out and give a few reactions and maybe even be inspired for your next Tinkercad creation. And about 30 minutes later, we've got a fidget. Bingo. Instantly movable. Of course, there are the initials. Let's go test it. And hold it with two fingers. And you can spin it. Simple system. You can see here that I can get a much tighter version of this. We could cut that distance down to 0.2 with the Bambu Labs printers. Make sure you stay tuned. I'll have a short where I likely do that. Of course, along with these fidgets, I have also got clicky fidgets. Make sure you check the links to see them as well. All right, so once again, I want to remind you, this project used to be created with cones. It was pretty slick, but there were a lot of steps and a lot of alignment. Now with the new Sketch Revolve tool, it's just bang. You draw the design, you leave the gap, and you end up with a cool print-in-place fun fidget. Of course, you can change that gap to find out what's best for your 3D printer. I use a gap of 1 millimeter because I found it worked with all my printers. You can experiment with shorter designs, whatever you want. If you're a teacher, of course, the faster they print, the easier it is to get the design in the hands of the students, which was always what mattered most to me. I do also want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. There are also members-only posts, so make sure you keep an eye out for them. I also want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We are past 300 members. It has a fantastic free messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, and post designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.